Hi, I'm Amir Hossein Mirza Buzurg, and in this video I want to talk about nonlinear dynamic analysis in Abaqus Part 2, Implicit vs. Explicit. How to ask your video related questions. Don't hesitate to ask any questions you might have about the explanations presented in this video using the comments below. We try to answer all questions regarding the video details in the comments below. This is the table of content. I will talk about steps for conducting nonlinear analysis in Abaqus, dynamic implicit step settings, solving the problem using dynamic implicit step, comparison of stress contours, comparing dynamic explicit and dynamic implicit results, applying filter to the results, and comparison of filtered and unfiltered results. This is the link of first part of this tutorial. In the first part of this tutorial, I talked about steps for conducting nonlinear analysis in Abaqus. If you want to use Abaqus Standard Solver, you must select dynamic implicit step. And if you want to use Abaqus Explicit Solver, you can select dynamic explicit step or dynamic temp disp explicit step. This step must be used to conduct coupled thermomechanical analysis. Now I want to talk about dynamic implicit step settings. In the basic tab, we must enter time period. If the simulation is dynamic, we must enter the real value for time period, and the time period and timing of the simulation is real. But if the simulation is quasi-static, we can enter an arbitrary value. And here we have the NLGM setting that can be set to on or off. And then we have the application setting. This setting is very important in the dynamic implicit step. It has three main states: transient fidelity, moderate dissipation, and quasi-static. About the transient fidelity, this state must be used in analyses such as the analysis of satellite system, which uses a small time increments to resolve the vibrational response of the structure accurately, and numerical energy dissipation is kept at a minimum. The other state is moderate dissipation. It must be used in analyses including various insertion, impact, and forming analyses, which use some energy dissipation via plasticity, viscous damping, or numerical effects to reduce solution noise and improve convergence behavior without significantly degrading solution accuracy. And the final state is quasi-static, and it must be used in analyses which introduce inertia effects primarily to regularize unstable behavior in analyses whose main focus is a final static response. Large time increments are taken when possible to minimize computational costs, and considerable numerical dissipation may be used to obtain convergence during certain stages of the loading history. And in the incrementation tab, we have these settings which are similar to the static general step settings. We must enter maximum number of increments, initial time increment size, and minimum time increment size, and we can specify the maximum increment size. In the previous part of this tutorial, we solved a simple dynamic problem using the dynamic explicit step. And in this tutorial, I want to solve it using the dynamic implicit step. And I will do this in two cases. In case one, the maximum increment size will be selected as 0.001 second. And in case two, the maximum increment size will be set to 0.00025 seconds. And in both of the cases, the reaction forces and moment will be saved in each increment size. Here we have the von Mises stress contours in both of the cases at the end of the analysis. In both of the cases, a displacement control loading has been applied to the tip of the beams, and it is its equation. In the left one, the amplitude of the displacement control loading is 0.2 meter and the NLGM is on and the time increment size is 0.001, and in the right one, the amplitude is equal to 0.2 meter, NLGM is on, and the time increment size is 0.00025 seconds. And as you can see, their stress contours are similar, but there is a little difference between their final shape. If you see accurately, you can see the difference between their shapes. And this is the reaction force in the y direction versus time for time increment size equal to 0.001 second. And this is the reaction force in the y direction versus time for time increment size equal to 0.00025. And here I have plotted both of the curves to compare them. As you can see, their general trend is similar. But in the result of the second case, we have more numerical noise. And as you can see, here we have larger amplitudes. Now I go to Abacus to show you the model's settings. Here we have all of the 10 models. The first 8 models are solved using the dynamic explicit step, and the remaining 2 models are solved using the dynamic implicit step. So I select model 9, and all of the models have the same settings in the part, property, assembly, interaction, load, and mesh modules. And they only differ in the step module settings. Here, I have defined a dynamic implicit step, and the time period is equal to 1, and the NLGM is set to on, and the application is set to moderate dissipation. And also, the initial and maximum time increment size are set to 0.001 second. And this is the field output settings, which is not important too much. And also, these are the settings of the history outputs. And here, I have set the interval to 1000 to have a set of data in each increment. Because I have set the maximum and initial time increment size to 0.001 second. And in model 10, also these settings are similar. And here the initial and maximum time increment size is set to 0.00025. And these settings are similar. Also, these ones are similar. But here, I have set the interval to 4000 because I want to have a set of data in each increment. And I go to the visualization module. And I open job 9 and job 10. And here I want to compare them. And here you can see the difference in their shapes. And here we have both of the reaction forces. I go back to the slides. Now I want to compare the results of dynamic explicit and dynamic implicit steps in the following slides. Here we have the result of model 8, model 9, and model 10. And as you can see, all of the stress contours are similar. And here the final shape of the beam is similar to this one. And here we have the comparison of reaction forces in the y direction. And if you see, the blue and green curves are similar to each other. And also, the general trend of all of the curves are similar. Now I want to use Butterworth filter to filter the results of model 8 and model 10. The Butterworth filter is one of the famous low-pass filters implemented in the Abacus visualization module. It will be applied to the results of dynamic explicit step and dynamic implicit step with time increment size equal to 0.00025. And here I will set the cutoff frequency to 85 Hz. This cutoff frequency has been found by trial and error. Now I want to compare the filtered results. Here we have the filtered reaction forces in the y direction for model 8 and model 10. And as you can see, they completely match to each other. And here we have the comparison of filtered and unfiltered results. And as you can see, the filtered results of model 8 and model 10 are more closer to the results of model 9. Now I go back to Abacus to do these comparisons. First of all, I delete these temporary XY data and I must open the result of model 8. And as you can see, these two shapes are more similar to each other. To apply filter, first I must create XY data from the history outputs. Then I apply filter to these XY data. And as you can see, they completely match to each other. And also, here we have good match. I go back to the slides. Now I want to talk about the conclusions. Comparing the results illustrates that we can obtain similar results using dynamic implicit and dynamic explicit steps. When using dynamic implicit or dynamic explicit steps, it is crucial to appropriately set the options of the step and the history output requests. In the following tutorials, I will talk about some of the important dynamic procedures, including ultrasonic processes, impact, crash, and explosion. You can contact me using Telegram or WhatsApp, or you can send email to me. We can have one-on-one tutoring on any desk, WhatsApp, and we can make special tutorials to your order. We can conduct high-quality simulations for your thesis, exercises, and industrial projects. Now I want to suggest you several related videos of our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a good time. Goodbye.